5-time U.S. National Ice Dance Champions Judy Blumberg and Michael Seibert completed their bronze medal performance at last year's World Championships. It was to the music Scheherazade. The same program and music used at the Olympic Games. But in Sarajevo, while they appeared assured of the bronze, a controversy over their music knocked them into fourth place. An Italian judge had ruled that their music was inappropriate and more suited to ice follies. The Americans were devastated, and they wanted to quit. But they came back 1 month later to the World Championships and announced their last amateur performance, only to finish third once again.
We got the medal. We placed third. Our performance was very unsatisfying. We didn't leave it the way we wanted to leave it.
It's terrible. Bad news.
They had lowered the curtain on their amateur career, but their own reviews of it all made them angry.
We didn't even talk to each other.
No, we just didn't really talk all summer. We saw each other once or twice.
We did not like each other this summer at all.
No, it was just like, get away, you know? Why?
Yes.
When we saw each other, it was like, yeah.
Don't touch.
And we didn't. And we didn't.
We've had it. We're done.
So the couple who for 6 years had spent few moments apart went their separate ways in New York City. The workouts continued, but they were without one another. And the only thing close to ice was the chill that had developed between the two of them. It was impossible to say goodbye to each other or to figure skating. They decided the partnership on ice would continue. The separation from the training and the sport had just made them both hungrier than ever for a world title.
We're coming back to win. We're coming back to say, this is where we belong. This is what we're good enough to have, and we want to have it.
It began with new music when they met a fan, composer Joel Silberman, who donated his talents. It took a while, but the music eventually spoke the language of ice dance. And now this team of three joins 60 musicians in a studio to record Fire on Ice. Become the tonic the ice dancers needed to again feel and talk like champions.
And why we're back is because I think you can have it all. And I think you can do it all. I think you can do something that's artistically important to you as individuals and please the audience. That is, who is important to us, and please the judges and be world champions.
But starting a new routine less than 6 months before competition is considered impossible.
She does slower.
I keep going back to that.
I know, because, I mean, they work for me.
Never too late. But we are late. We've taken a whole summer off. That's unheard of.
One, two, three.
Sorry. We're working well, and our minds are working together more efficiently, and we're getting things done, and... consistency is coming, something that really has never come so quickly.
And then right down. That's your work.
The program this year will allow our personalities to show through, and that's what we need, because people enjoy that. People like us.
We enjoy that, but we haven't been doing that.
We've been just really getting into the drama, which is was important for us to do. Now we're coming back and moving forward, and we'll show you who Judy and Mike really are.
Judy and Michael, getting ready to skate here at the World Figure Skating Championships. We'll be back. So now, in the bronze medal position, entering the free dance, the best American ice dancers, Judy Blumberg, Michael Seibert.
Thank you. They are skating to Fire on Ice, composed by, of course, Joel Silverman. The first time American ice dancers have skated to original music.
Well, last year, that was the reason that was given for not winning a bronze medal, and it seems that's a great attitude. It's take that, judges. We're going to give you something that we can dance to. Very original move there. And again.
It's interesting, when they first used this music in competition at the United States Nationals, it didn't work quite properly because they said that they couldn't really feel the rhythm. So they took it back into the studio, remixed it, made the drums louder, and they say that it's easier to dance to now.
Well, I can feel it in my seat, so I know the drums are a little bit better. Great, I've never seen Michael look more relaxed and happy about skating. I room with him every World Championship, and he always is a little nervous around this time, but been all smiles and so relaxed and so up the whole week.
When they recorded this music in New York City.
Moonwalk.
And every member of the 60-piece orchestra knew where this music was going, and it really was a special moment.
It's fun. You know, we've had the heavy, we've had the dramatic, and we've had the traditional, and now we're seeing something really contemporary, and it's a lot of fun to watch. It's so hard. What they're doing is so difficult. Non-stop, twisting around here. Oh. The steps, the lift, they all intertwine beautifully, and it's so difficult. Do not do that in your living room, ladies and gentlemen.
Championship bronze last year, they told the world they would stop skating in amateur competition, changed their mind, came back, and now entering the free dance that they just completed, they're in bronze medal territory, trying to hang on, perhaps move up into a silver.
When you leave something like that, they left a little bitter, they came back, and I think they're stronger than ever.
Blumberg and Seibert leaving the ice and waiting for their first set of scores to see if they have a chance at taking the silver away from the second Soviet couple. And the two highest scores are 2.58. So depending on what we see in artistic impression, that should keep them in the bronze, but really no chance to move up into silver.
Well, they skated their best. That's what they came to do, and it's really out of their hands now.
The second set of scores will come up for artistic impression now. And whoa, a low of 5.6 from the Canadian judge, the United States judge on the other end there with a 5.9, and the rest are 5.8. That pretty much assures them of bronze, but they will not be able to take that silver away from Ponomarenko and Klimova.
Let's take a look at the last lift they did in their program. It's very original. He's not allowed to lift her above his shoulder. She swoops down. This is very, very dangerous. And then he brings her back up, and they have a little stumble here, but it wasn't that serious.
Right now, let's go down to John Misha Petkovic.
Judy, that was unquestionably a great performance. Was it everything you wanted?
I was pleased with it. We wanted to go out and skate well.
The energy was real good. We had a little problem at the end.
few other little places, but the energy was there, and I'm real happy.
And we were with the crowd, and they were with us.
Is this going to be your last amateur performance? Is this the last time we see you in the World Championships?
You asked us that this last year, and we said yes.